Hello students, in our today's class, we will study about Standard 12th Physics Volume 1, Unit 1, Section 1.8, that is Capacitors and Capacitance, in which we will see Section 1.8.1, that is Capacitors, and further, we will see about Capacitance of a Parallel Plate Capacitor. How is it measured and what are the terms which we use to find out or to calculate Capacitance. If you are new to my channel, Pratik Singh Classes, please subscribe it. Do like and share my channel so that everybody can get benefits from my knowledge, and please hit the bell icon so that whenever I will upload a new video, you will get its instant notification. Fine, so welcome to my YouTube channel Pratik Singh Classes, and let us start our today's class, that is Capacitors and Capacitance. Okay, so today's topic is Capacitors and Capacitance. Capacitors are too much important in our day-to-day electrical and electronic devices. Fine, so let us start our today's topic, section 1.8.1. Capacitor is a device used to store electric charge and electrical energy. Okay, you might have seen batteries, different types of batteries like primary and secondary batteries. Okay, same thing is capacitor, it stores electric charge and electrical energy, but there is some certain difference between a battery and a capacitor. Okay, we will study about that later, but till now just remember that capacitor works the same way as a cell or a battery does. Okay, fine. It consists of two conducting objects, usually plates or sheets, separated by some distance. Okay, that means there will be a box, maybe of any shape, circular, triangular, rectangular, or any other shape. Okay, and there will be two or more than two plates. Okay, in which there will be gap between them. Okay, capacitors are widely used in many electronic circuits and have applications in many areas of science and technology. Without capacitor, we can't imagine modern computing. Fine, so what are its benefits, what are its uses, what are its applications in day-to-day life? Okay, then how does it affect if it will not be available for us? Fine, so about those things we will study in this topic, section 1.8. Okay, fine. So a simple capacitor consists of two parallel metal plates separated by a small distance, as shown in figure here. Okay, in this figure A, 1.54A, you can see that there are two plates. Okay, this is first and this is second, and there is a very small gap between them. Okay, and you can see that the electric field lines are going from left to right. That means this plate is positively charged and this plate is negatively charged. Okay, so this is a parallel plate capacitor. Fine, in figure B you can see that the capacitor is connected with a battery. Here is a battery and here is the capacitor, and they are connected. Okay, can you please say me in what type of connection it is? Is it parallel or series? Mention this thing in my comment section of this video. And then here is the symbol of a capacitor connected with a battery. Okay, see, the symbol difference between a capacitor and a battery is very, very similar. Okay, as you can see that two parallel lines with same height are the symbol of capacitor, whereas two parallel lines, one is smaller and one bigger, is the symbol of a cell or a battery. Fine, coming to next topic. Okay, so let me say myself that here figure 1.54C is the symbolic representation of figure B, and as you can see here, figure B, okay, and figure C, if you compare, you can see that capacitor is in series connection with a battery here. Okay, as you can see, they are connected in series connection. Okay, about series and parallel connection, you have studied very well in class 9th, 10th and 11th. So not going to that much deep, but whenever the topic series connection and parallel connection will come in our topic, in our book, okay, I will tell you a little things about that so that you can recollect all the data which you have studied earlier. Now coming to the theory part, when a capacitor is connected to a battery of potential V, as you have seen in figure 1.54B and C, that suppose the potential of the battery is V, the electrons are transferred from one plate to the other plate by battery so that one plate becomes negatively charged with a charge of minus Q and the other plate becomes positively charged with a charge of plus Q. Okay, so let us come back once again in figure 1.54 B and C. Okay, as you can see here in this figure 1.54B that suppose the potential of the battery here is V and a capacitor is attached to the battery in series. Because of that, the charges will flow from the battery to the capacitor. Okay, as you can see here, the negative terminal of the battery is connected to one of the plate and the positive terminal of the battery is connected to the other plate. Okay, the charges will flow. You know very well that charges flow from negative terminal to positive terminal outside the battery. Okay, so the plate, this plate will become negatively charged, or because the battery will provide a lot of electrons to this, this plate will become negatively charged and that will be of minus Q. Okay, likewise this plate will become positively charged of the magnitude plus Q. Okay, so I hope you have understood the theory and the concept very well. Now let us move back to theory part again. Fine, the potential difference between the plates is equivalent to the battery's terminal voltage. Okay, so whatever will be the battery's terminal voltage, same will be the potential difference between the plates of the capacitor as shown in figure 1.54b. If the battery voltage is increased, the amount of charge stored in the plates also increases. Means if suppose the capacity of the battery will increase, that much capacity of the charges will run towards the capacitor plates and so the capacity of the capacitor will also increase. In general, the charge stored in the capacitor is proportional to the potential difference between the plates. As you can see here, Q is directly proportional to V. Okay, so to remove this sign of proportionality, we have to multiply it with some proportionality constant and that is C. Okay, so we can write here Q is equal to C into V, where C is the proportionality constant called the capacitance. This depends on the capacitor. The capacitance C of a capacitor is defined as the ratio of the magnitude of charge on either of the conductor plate to the potential difference existing between the conductors. Means just take one of the plate of the capacitor and then find out how much is the amount of charge available on that plate and divide that charge with the potential difference of the battery. That will give you the capacitance of the capacitor. Fine, all right. Okay, the SI unit of capacitance is coulomb per volt or farad. Okay, so as you can see from this equation 1.81, okay, that C is the capacitance, Q is the charge and V is the voltage. So the unit of charge is coulomb and the unit of potential is voltage. So the unit of capacitance will become coulomb per volt, or this is also called as farad in the honor of Michael Faraday. Farad is a very large unit of capacitance. In practice, the capacitors are available in the range of microfarad, okay, to picofarad. Micro means 10 to the power minus 6 and pico means 10 to the power minus 12. 1 farad is a huge quantity. So instead of using this, we use in our day-to-day life as microfarad to picofarad. A capacitor is represented by this symbol, okay, two parallel lines with same height or one line and one brushes, okay, both are the symbol of capacitor. But keep in mind that in both of them the height should be equal. If you make one a smaller and one bigger, okay, then that will become the symbol of a cell. Okay, even if you use like this, it will also be called as a cell. So keep in mind of that thing. Note that the total charge stored in the capacitor is zero. That is Q minus Q is equal to zero. That is charge on one plate minus charge on the other plate. When we say the capacitor stores charges, it means the amount of charge that can be stored on any one of the plates. Okay, so if suppose we say that a capacitor is storing X farad or X unit of charge, then we say that X unit of charge is either on the positive plate or the negative plate, any one. Fine, Nowadays, there are capacitors available in various shapes like cylindrical, disc, pyramidal, and different types of capacitors are also there, like tantalum capacitor, ceramic capacitor, electrolytic capacitor, depending upon for what purpose we are using that. Okay, as shown in figure 1.55, let us see what is that. Okay, so as you can see in this figure 1.55, okay, we have different types of capacitors and also different materials are used here to make the capacitors. As you can see here, cylindrical capacitor, circular capacitor, okay, and then disc capacitor. Fine, these capacitors are extensively used in various kinds of electronic circuits. Okay, even if you see your digital clock, digital watches that use capacitors, okay, whatever thing of electronics you see around you, okay, whether it is too to a small, okay, or far far bigger, all of them uses capacitors in one or the other way. Fine, so without this, present day electronic components cannot be possible. Okay, now coming to the next topic, that is capacitance of a parallel plate capacitors. See, capacitors are connected with each other in either two ways. One is either parallel or either in series. We will see both one by one. So now we will see first capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor. Fine. Consider a capacitor with two parallel plates, each of cross-sectional area A and separated by a distance D as shown in figure 1.56. Okay, as you can see here, let me enlarge this figure. Okay, so you can see here, okay, the cross-sectional area of both of the plates are A, okay, and then this is the left side plate is positively charged with the charge amount plus Q, and the right side plate is negatively charged with charge amount minus Q. The separation between the positive plate and the negative plate is small d, as you can see here, and as you can see here, the electric field lines are going from positive plate to negative plate. You know very well from our previous video that from positive charges electric field lines comes out, and to negative charge the electric field lines will go inside. Same thing we have to apply everywhere, wherever we will see the concept of positive charge or positive plate, likewise negative charge or negative plate. Fine, very well. Okay, the electric field between the two infinite parallel plate is uniform and is given by E is equal to sigma by epsilon naught. About this thing, we already have seen in our previous video. If you haven't seen the previous video, please go through that to understand the things very well. Fine, here sigma is the surface charge density, okay, on the plate, that is sigma is equal to QIA, that is total amount of charge on any one of the plate divided by its cross-sectional area. If the separation distance D is very much smaller than the size of the plate, that is dA square is far far lesser than A, then the above result is used even for finite sized parallel plate capacitor. Okay, the electric field between the plate is given by E is equal to Q by A into epsilon naught. Okay, as this equation can be taken out from this equation, that is E is equal to sigma by epsilon naught, where sigma is equal to Q by A, so E is equal to Q by A into epsilon naught. Okay, since the electric field is uniform, the electric potential between the plates having separation D is given by V is equal to E into D is equal to QD by A into epsilon naught, where Q is the total charge, D is the distance between the plates, A is the cross-sectional area of the plate, and epsilon naught is the permittivity of free space. Therefore, the capacitance of the capacitor is given by C is equal to Q by V. Just substitute the value of V here from equation 1.83, you will get C is equal to Q by QD by A into epsilon naught, or C is equal to epsilon naught A into D. Fine. So I hope you have understood here how to find out the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor. Okay, From equation 1.84, it is evident that capacitance is directly proportional to the area of cross-section. That means higher will be the area, larger will be the area, larger will be the capacitance, and inversely proportional to the distance between the plates. That means if the distance between the plates will increase, capacitance will decrease and vice versa. Okay, so this can be understood from the following two paragraphs, following two theories. Okay, number one, if the area of cross-section of the capacitor plate is increased, that means if A value will increase, more charges can be distributed for the same potential difference. Means in that situation, even if keeping the potential of the battery same, okay, higher number of charges can be induced in the capacitor plate. So as a result, the capacitance of the capacitor will increase. Okay, second number. Okay, so if the distance d between two plates is reduced, means if the distance between the plates, that t value will decrease, in that situation the potential between the plates decreases while keeping e value constant. Okay, as a result, voltage difference between the terminals of the battery increases, which in turn leads to an additional flow of charge to the plates from the battery. So till the voltage on the capacitor equals the battery's terminal voltage. Okay, so that means till the time the voltage difference will happen between the capacitor plates and the battery, the charges will flow from the battery to the capacitor. Okay, once the potential difference on the battery and on the capacitor becomes equal, the charge flow will stop. Suppose the distance is increased, the capacitor voltage increases and becomes greater than the battery voltage. Then the charge flows from capacitor plates to the battery till both voltage becomes equal. Okay, so just keep in mind, in whatever direction the voltage will be higher, okay, the charges will flow towards the lower terminal voltage. Okay, if suppose the voltage on the battery will be higher, the charges will flow from the battery to the capacitor, and if the voltage difference on the capacitor plates will become higher than the battery, the charges will flow from the capacitor towards the battery till the time they becomes equal. So this is the end of our today's video, that is about capacitors and capacitance and how to calculate capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor. I hope you might have enjoyed the class and have learned something new. Okay, keep watching and liking my channel Pratik Singh Classes, and every time you will get ample of knowledge from my videos. Fine, till my next video, take care of yourself. Bye bye.